What if we cancel those plans and take mushrooms instead? Also on June 13th, we have another aspect that really kind of emphasizes opening to possibilities and magic and potential. And this would be the Sun in Gemini square to Neptune in Pisces. And so, you know, this is a dual sign Gemini, so we're gonna see the highs and the lows of this aspect. Number one, this can really lift and alleviate us out of anything that feels leaden or heavy or just too basic and kind of a drag, you know? It's like time to kind of find magic and seek experiences that lift us out and provide us with sparkly stories to tell. And just like really connected, plugged in experiences. So we're seeking magic, we're seeking adventure under this aspect. The other thing that it can do though is it can be kind of dizzying. It can be a little overwhelming. It's like this theme that we've kept seeing through Gemini season as all of these planets square off with Neptune is just there's the idea that there's too many options and we can't really plan for the future because we don't really know what tomorrow looks like, or we don't really know which path we're going to end up taking. And it's kind of reflective, I feel, of, I mean, we've been running into this through Gemini season, right? But it's like really emphasized this time around with Mercury's ongoing square to Neptune and the eclipses square to Neptune and last year's Venus retrograde square to Neptune for a very extended time. So we're getting a lot of Neptune right now, which is a lot of confusion. And also just feeling overwhelmed too. Like, you know, I've said it many times before and I'll say it again. We don't have to have all the answers right now. This can just be about curiosity and discovery and a willingness to learn and a willingness to, you know, learn as we go. Like it doesn't have to be this big formal thing. Like we don't have to have the answers. So that can certainly take some of the pressure off with this aspect. But for people who struggle with anxiety or people who struggle otherwise, you know, with being able to like stay focused and things like that, this is one of those aspects that isn't maybe the easiest or the most conducive. So what we really want to do during this time, if you're already feeling overwhelmed with everything going on, to really call on your grounded friends who can offer some perspective. Because when the Sun squares Neptune, or really when anything squares off with Neptune, we can let these kind of ideal scenarios run away with us for better or for worse. You know, sometimes that's a good thing. Sometimes we need to believe that something else is possible. And, you know, it's because everything that ever has existed has begun with a vision, has begun with a hope, has begun with a dream. And so it's really thrilling and alluring and elevating to let that dream kind of run away with us. But the trouble is the disappointment, right? Because not everything falls into shape with our perception of what's ideal. And on the flip, you know, this aspect can produce a lot of worrying about scenarios that haven't happened or may never happen. And that's part of like the anxiety script of just like worrying about things that haven't happened or things that could happen. So this aspect could provoke a little bit of that. So my advice for handling this aspect is definitely plan, like, you know, we're just coming out of eclipse season. Give yourself some space. Give yourself some space. Like, we're not going to be fully out of the eclipse season probably until Mercury actually, that's a ways away, so maybe not that far away. But we're not going to be really out of Neptune land until Mercury leaves Gemini. So how about that? So until then, you know, give yourself some space and allow yourself to just have some time to float, you know. Even if you're just like a really goal-oriented person and you want to achieve A, B, C, and D by this time next year, blah, blah, blah. You know, right now, these Neptune aspects are inviting us to just float, just take a step back, just trust the process, you know, have faith that it'll all work out, have faith that you'll have the information that you need and that the opportunity that you're trying to manifest or that you're waiting for to make itself known is going to show up at some point in time. So, I mean, that's kind of a Neptune, Sun Square Neptune keyword is, it will all work out. It will all work out. So, yeah, that's it. That's it, everyone. And, yeah, have a great week. Thanks so much for joining me today. For more astrology in your world, you can connect with me on Instagram or Twitter or Patreon at AstroCatherine. You can book your reading with me at my website, and I look forward to connecting with you.